Hello, Airbus Cockpit Coach here, and welcome to the channel. In this video, we're going to dive into a very useful tool we have inside our MCDU interfaces in the A320, and that's the secondary flight plan. We're going to see what it is, how it's used, and why it matters. Let's dive in. Before we do that, don't forget to hit the thumbs up button and give the video a like. So our secondary flight plan page is found by pressing SEC F-PLAN on the MCDU interface. And you'll get this page here, titled SEC Index. The best way of describing a secondary flight plan is a Plan B. And what our Plan B is will vary depending on what phase of flight we are in. Plan Bs aren't always for emergency scenarios, they may be for operational or air traffic control reasons as well. What we'd normally do here is copy the active. So in the flight plan page, here we have our active flight plan. So this is the routing the aircraft will fly currently. Regardless of whether you need a Plan B or not, it's always a good practice to have a copy of your current active flight plan. So to copy your active, simply press the top line select there against copy active, and that will then copy the routes that you have in the active into the secondary. There it is, in white. At the moment, we're thinking about our departure. The first Plan B we'll need will be what will happen if we take off and have an emergency and we need to return to our departure aerodrome. Or, if that's not a possibility, our takeoff alternate. I have another video on how to insert engine out procedures, for example, so that's the usual worst case we put in. To do this, we use place-bearing distance waypoints. But today, we'll continue out on runway heading, tracking 254 off Luton's runway 25. So, just to run through this quickly again. Echo Golf Golf Whiskey, so Luton, runway 25, tracking 254, and we'll continue out for 25 miles. We need to enter this into line select key 3. Normally we'd put it into 2. There's a little bit of a bug with the Fenix, so it goes into line 3. The first waypoint is 254 anyway, so that won't change anything. But we could take out altitude constraint, for example, on an engine failure. May not necessarily want that in there. We come up to our navigation display now. We'll see, because we have the secondary flight plan page open, we'll see that track there. And then what we can do, we can enter the hold at that waypoint. So we can enter the hold on track 254, for example, left or right turns. And to visualize that, we can come into our plan page up here and then simply scroll through on the secondary flight plan. And there you got it, coming off the runway, right-hand turns, entering on track 254. And then, of course, we can select a new destination. We can just select any waypoint there on the right. And then from here, we can put in arrival runway as normal. I mean, ILS 25. Very unlikely to fly a star if we're in an engine failure situation. It's going to be vectors. Won't normally complete that. But we can come in and go to the secondary flight planner page again and go to perf, and then we can run through the performance for the secondary as well, and we can put in all our approach information there for London Luton for an immediate return. That's the first scenario, and to simply activate the flight plan. So if we had that engine failure on departure, we'd come to secondary flight plan page, would activate the secondary, and that will then appear in here, and we can fly to those waypoints as required. So once we're in the air and we pass 10,000 feet, we would generally clear out what's in our secondary, so our engine out plan, we haven't used it hopefully, and we no longer need that in there. It's not relevant to that stage of the flight. We would simply come to delete secondary, and then most likely we would recopy the active at that stage, so we always have a copy of the active flight plan. So at this stage, we use the secondary flight plan to start thinking about en route diversions. So what are our Plan Bs en route? And we can also use it if, for example, we saw an area of weather coming up on the weather radar. We thought, actually, okay, we're flying along on a particular heading or a current waypoint, but we notice that we've got bad weather ahead of us. We could ask, obviously, for a vector around it, or we can look at other waypoints around us, and we could put that into the secondary and see, actually, if we routed to a different waypoint, for example, that would take us around that weather. So we can simply enter the fix here and input that as our next waypoint while we're flying along. And if that takes us around the radar return on our screen, we could say to air traffic control, we'd like to go to VOR XYZ, and that may be approved or denied. Plotting a track around weather is another example of where we can use the secondary flight plan. So for diversions, we can simply change the destination. So we could be flying along and going up from Luton to Edinburgh, maybe Manchester is an alternate. And again, we can start setting up an arrival into Manchester. Selecting the runway and the likely star from our direction as well, we could select. We may be able to get that information from the ATIS. And we can go as far as putting the performance information in for Manchester's arrival. So this is generally something the pilot monitoring will be doing during cruise, keeping these options open and ready to go. We can also use it for terrain escape manoeuvres, so if we're crossing the Alps, for example, and we know that it will be preferable to turn to the east towards a particular waypoint to avoid the highest terrain, we can enter that waypoint into our secondary flight plan and we can turn to that straight away. We've got an immediate reference of where that is, for example, so it can be used for that kind of scenario as well. Remember, you want the most relevant information here, so if we pass Manchester and it's not an option anymore, it's not sensible to fly to Manchester, we'd delete the secondary, recopy the active, and that's a process we continue throughout the flight. One thing we can also do in here is, in advance of perhaps entering a hold, we can set the hold up in here, for example, over a waypoint. So we have a waypoint here on the screen actually we can use, so we can enter a hold there and say this is on our arrival, particular inbound course. We can visualize the hold before we put it in the active flight plan. Does that make sense or not? Yeah, that does make sense. So we can then go into the active flight plan and then insert the same data again. So we can sort of visualize things before we actually put that into the active flight plan. Just handy to do. Coming into the arrival phase, there are many airports out there which have multiple runways, multiple approaches, and dual runway operations for landing. We can get switched, for example, from one runway to the other. That's another example of where we'd simply come in and we can select a different arrival. We could put a different runway in for our arrival, a different star, for example, and be ready to go and just hit the activate secondary flight plan if we're given that clearance from air traffic control. That's particularly useful, and that's one example where we'd use the secondary quite a lot. If we had to perform a missed approach, we're likely to be put into a hold. And from there, if we decided that actually we need to divert, current destination is not an option, that's generally where we start plotting away in the secondary flight plan, requesting a routing from air traffic control. They'll go and get that for us, and we'll put those into the secondary, verify that information, and then activate that once we're happy. Then not forgetting to recopy the active flight plan again into the secondary, so that's always available. So we can just plot waypoints, any waypoints you want in here, so be flying along. We can vary it as much as you want, just simply inserting the fixes. We can put airways in, so we can go via a particular airway. And we can also put restrictions as required against those as well, speed restrictions and altitude constraints. So we can build the flight plan without risk to the current flight plan here, verify that and activate when we're happy. Something that some pilots do is use the secondary flight plan to prepare for a turnaround. So it is possible to put in your next flight into the secondary. So coming in, we've got a short turnaround, for example, we can come into the secondary, We can delete the secondary that's currently there. We can come into the init page on the secondary, and we can put a return leg in if you like. So Edinburgh back to London Luton, and enter all this information. If we've got the flight plan already, we can do init B for fuel planning, and then we can come to the actual plan itself, put our departure runway in, so basically building up as you would do for any of our flights on the ground. We'd throw this information in, put the routing in, build it up, verify, put your arrival in, and we can do all the performance against that as well. That all goes in, even the takeoff calculations if you know your weights. So you have got the information, that is an option. It's not one I'm a big fan of. I think that we should be in flight focusing on the current flight. We certainly don't want to have the risk of activating that secondary and losing your current flight plan. It's not one I use myself, but some operators do use the secondary flight plan for that purpose, and that is an option for you in the simulator, of course. So that's a bit of an overview of the secondary flight plan. As you can see, it's a very useful tool. We will always have something in there, whether it's just a copy of the active. Make full use of it. We should be exploring our plan Bs and entering those in there, so we're as prepared as possible at any given moment for particular scenarios. If you have any questions on that at all, please use the comments box below. I'll do my best to answer those. And don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button, and I'll catch you on the next one. Thanks for watching.